Hi there. I am here to say that I missed something very important. With my Send a Smiles, I forgot to say that I did send the reversible ornaments to Two Needles Pulling Thread, Kathy and Missy, and they were so kind in their response to what I sent them. I really do believe that you are all watching their channel, but just in case, I really enjoy how they go back and forth. They are like sisters-in-laws. One of them married the brother of the person, sort of thing. And they get along so well, and their approach to their channel is to be gracious and straightening of the crown. The overall feeling is so uplifting throughout their entire set of videos that I felt that I needed to thank them for being such a lovely example for what I would like to be someday. So thank you to Missy and Kathy for their lovely words of support and analysis of my work on their recent video. Now back to regular programming. Hello and welcome or welcome back. It is time to talk about cross stitch with the Stitching Owl. Today is April the 8th in 2024, and it is a special day because a lot of North America has the opportunity to observe an eclipse with their family. So I hope that in your neck of the woods, this is a wonderful opportunity and that you have those special glasses that make it safe to look up and be in absolute awe of what is happening. Apparently it's going to be at least, I think, around 20 years till this happens again. So it's worth taking a moment out of your day. In the last couple of weeks, I hope you found enough time to stitch and make something beautiful. We always have to remember that when we sit down for a few moments, we are helping to make ourselves more peaceful, and we're taking care of ourselves, so therefore we are taking care of others when we sit down to stitch. Isn't that wonderful? We need to make sure we take care of others a lot. And if you are new to the channel, and perhaps a new subscriber since last time, thank you so much for hitting the subscribe button. I truly appreciate it. And thank you for giving me the opportunity to spend a few minutes with you. I hope that you have something to stitch and a beverage of your choice so that we can just have a little bit of time together. I would like to start my floss tube today with thank yous. Thank you to Rose of Untwist Your Stitches. Yes, I had to double check that I said that correctly. She has a floss tube and she gave me a lovely shout out. It is nice to actually have someone else who is running somewhat parallel in their floss tube journey and understand what it's like to be in your first 6 months and looking forward and finding your way with all the different things we have to do when we are a floss tuber. So I hope you'll give Rose a quick look at Untwist Your Stitchers. And I'd also like to say thank you to the Sun City Stitchers, who I have been watching, well, from before I was a floss tuber. Carlene and Marlene are twins who love to stitch together, cook together, decorate together, and of course floss tube together. They know each other so well, they can finish each other's sentences, and they have a delightful way of doing some projects parallel and the same, while others are quite different. So I just find them a delight to watch, and I would really love to encourage everybody to give them a subscribe. They're close to that 1,000 subscribers. I would surely like for them to reach that signpost. Stitching on the Rock, Deanne. I have been watching her and enjoying her probably for a little bit longer than I've been a floss tour. She's a fellow Canadian, and she's from the East Coast. She's on the rock. I'm going to invite you to actually have a watch so that you fully understand that reference. Now, Deanne has had a recent parade, and it was lovely to watch. Go back one or two videos, I think one, and you will have a lovely time in it. She had a giveaway, and I was delighted to discover that I won my choice of patterns at Darlene Dion's website. Well, she's on Etsy, and she's a fellow Canadian who is a floss tuber, Darlene Dion. Now, D-E-O-N. I had a hard time finding her, so humorously, I thought people were saying darling, and so I was doing D-A-R-L-I-N-G and D-I-O-N-N-E. I'm wondering how on earth it was that there could be a designer that didn't want to be found. Well, I just had all spellings completely wrong. And so I'm totally delighted that I have this opportunity to pick out one. I have to admit that I have been looking, and I might have to buy one myself because I don't think I can get it down to one. I think there's a couple that I want, and I will surely be stitching soon. I'm delighted that Darlene actually provides a few of her patterns with gentle Canadian patriotism, with our flag available, and that's something that a lot of the designers out there, like in the States, they're of course going to do the American flags, and there's a few like Kathy Haberman that delightfully provide a Canadian option, and of course Jeanette Douglas, she does Canadian patriotic ideas. Darlene Dion, she's got a couple pages of patterns and they're lovely. And for you multi-crafters, she does quilting and quilting design as well. So we can watch her video right after we watch Stitching on the Rock. And we can also visit her on Etsy. And the last thank you, just before I get on to actually, yes, some stitching. Two Bay Stitchers. And when you put that into YouTube, I want you to put the number 2. I'm just going to put it up here so that you can see it. Again, fellow Canadians, in the last few weeks, I've been doing a little bit of brainstorming with the Two Bay Stitchers. And I've had a couple of Zooms, and it has been so lovely to get to know somebody that I wish was right around the corner and I could stitch with in person. The last time I had everything set to stitch while I was talking, and I got so into the conversation I didn't even put in one stitch. But it is absolutely lovely to get to know them. They have, I'd say, monthly videos, Two Bay Stitchers, and that between them, they've got, for me, a really lovely length of video. I like to watch different lengths. For them, if I want to get in a nice, gentle, but encouraging myself to do a long walk, I can watch their video and know that by the end of it, I've got 4K in or so. And so in that way, thank you. Thank you to Michelle and Cheryl for helping to keep me healthy and for becoming my friend. I really appreciate it. And I'm just going to invite you all to visit us at the beginning of May and very end of April for a special announcement. If you go and watch the video that the Two Bay Stitchers posted yesterday, you'll get even more of a sneak hint as to what is happening. As to my Send a Smiles, I do have a number out right now. I am going beyond just sending ornaments. There are other things in some cases being sent in the mail and sometimes being sent electronically. So I've had a variety. I've had a box, two envelopes, and an electronic smile go out in the last little while, and I have plans to do another one of those today. It is so much fun to know that I can share stitching and the joy of stitching and the joy of giving my stitching to somebody that will appreciate it to people all over the world. So if you're watching and you're thinking, oh, I live in fill in the blank, she wouldn't want to send to me. Oh, yes, I do. I would love to be able to send an ornament to as many countries in the world as possible. So right now it has been Canada, United States, Ireland, and England. I would love to send further. It is so much fun to share. And congratulations to Cinematic Stitches, happy Flossiversary, as well as, okay, I'm gonna put it up here, Cross My Stitches Floss Tube for, she's gonna have 6 years as a floss tuber. That is absolutely awesome. Let's do some stitching. Okay, fully finishes. I got a couple of fully finishes, not a huge amount, but I have, this is my October and this is my November of the Au Fil de Mes Choix, the birdhouse. Pattern is by Jardin Privé and it is a sew along that is being run by Colette the Highway Stitcher as well as Brenda the Handwork Maniac. It has multiple hashtags. Most people are doing, oh my goodness, the phone is actually going to ring. So most people, when they are doing the Jardin Privé, are looking at not doing that one. Oh, they're looking at doing an entire picture. Now, be that as it may, when I saw that there was 12 months, I thought, hey, I can do 12 ornaments. And I contacted Colette, she was fine with this. So I'm doing these on 28 count Even Weave Panettone by Roxy Floss Co. And I am actually using one strand of DMC over one, mostly given colors or at least inspired by the given DMC colors. Lots of fun. Now, when you press the button to watch my video today, it was 50 is a fabulous number. And why is 50 a fabulous number? It means I got halfway done in something. So we are going to find out later on that I am halfway with my birdhouse now. So these were finishes. I've also been just experimenting at the sewing machine. Some of my project bags do not have vinyl fronts. Canada is like this. Sometimes with the humidity in the summer is amazing and then everything sticks to vinyl and I don't want to have oopsed and have the actual pattern. Yeah, I don't want to create a mess. So frequently I don't have vinyl at the front. So that means I have to remember what's in them, or I decided I was going to try making a luggage tag. So this was a past project in quilting that was just a little bit left over. You'll probably see it again on the back of some ornaments. And then the vinyl that I'm not using as much for my project bags, I have here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a card in here so that I can put the project and the details that I would want to know when I'm doing my floss tube so that it's an easy reference. So my youngest, whom you met at the last video, is helping me with this rivet stuff. I don't have a lovely rivet press because they're quite expensive. So I've just got this hand one and Derica's doing a lovely job. We'll see whether she's willing to do a whole bunch of this. That's it for my fully finishes. Now, with regards to finishes, which comes next, usually I've got a wide array of those. Notice the word usually there. So for me, I have one Quaker. So I am doing the Bake Me a Quaker Sal with the Sunshine Stitchers, EJ and Shelia, who have a wonderful floss tube, and they are going to be hosts on the next cruise in January of 2025 for Jean Farish's stitching cruise. So, oh, that was very tempting to do. So what we have is, let me show you. I know I brought it down. I seriously brought it down. Yes, I did. One Dozen Quakers by Rosewood Manor. So this is really what Shelia and EJ had predicted people would do. Now, that multitudes of colorings, that's the joy of this. Different ranges of fabrics. But again, just like in the Ophie de Nichois, I actually decided I was just going to do ornaments. And by doing that, I would be able to do more than one dozen Quakers out of that pattern. I mean, my goal is that each month I will make four Quakers into ornaments. And so this is a new one. I will be doing it on point. I know it's a square, but I'll be putting, we call it on point when we are in quilting. So I've got a few beads on this one. This is 32 count even weave. It's an aqua splash. And I used my 12 weight sulky threads. So much fun. So that's it for my finishes, but I'm going to do my bravo to my daughter, who finished two more products herself. And she's starting to do things that are just a little bit bigger. So she has friends that are getting married and are bookies. They love to read. And so she did the bookshelf from Maria Brovko on Cute Patterns by Maria. If I zoom in, you can actually see there is a Narnia shelf, a Hobbit shelf, and a Harry Potter shelf. Now, this didn't take her all that long to do. I would say less than 6 weeks, which I feel is so commendable. Very, very delighted that she is finding how meditative it is. And then, okay, I'm gonna try and do this so that I don't mess up the ironing that I had just accomplished. She borrowed one of my tiny modernist patterns, and it is a birdhouse pattern, very colorful. And she finished it as well. Well, I'm going to say 99.9% finished, because I just noticed before I started that the hanger from house number 4 is absent. But isn't this adorable? She's got lovely, I think she used all of the called for colors of DMC, 2 strands over 1. And I think that this was just one of my white pieces of Aida that I got from Amazon when I started getting curious about stitching again. It's still, after all the stitching, it's still stiff. Now, she has asked for me to consider framing this one that is the bookshelf. So I have to decide whether I'm gonna have to look around and see whether something my mom or I have might work for that, or whether I might be having something more creative. So, yay, bravo. And that's it for my finishes, which brings us up to works in progress. Oh my. Okay, so let's see what I can do to not be tongue-tied here. This might be one of my quicker videos. So the first one that I'm going to talk about is going to be the Quaker Flags by, and I forgot to write it down, Vivian at Vivsters, Vivian Powers. She's on Etsy and is a skilled pattern setter who has done many of the flags in the wall in the world. I, of course, am doing the Canadian flag, and I did not write down how many stitches on my little piece of paper. Rats. So I don't know how many I'm in, but I can tell you that at this point, I have kept up with my goal of completing one block per week. So I actually have 8 designs. This was my most recent one. Is that not gorgeous? And I like how she balances this. This one has more open back fabric showing next to one that has less back fabric. But at each one of these having a little over 600, I am getting into this. I do know that the last time I checked yesterday, I was at 10% complete. So if that's 10%, that would mean there's about 80 boxes, which is more than one a week. But it is what it is. That's what I'm going to do now. I forgot to bring over a chair. We'll see if my delightful husband is going to pass at any point. Today was haircut day for our dog, so she's coming back 2 sizes smaller just by having a haircut. Wouldn't it be great if that's what I could do? Yes, indeed. I have to say, I've also had the opportunity to be taking care of a bunny for 2 months. Our neighbors have an outdoor bunny hutch, and they are away, and it is just so much fun. I've learned a lot, and I now know that if I say, "Hi, Buster," as I'm coming into the backyard, he comes out, he's a big bunny. I'll try and have a picture. Not sure if I will or not. And then when I put my hand into his area, he flops over on his side. I have discovered that a bunny flop is a compliment of all compliments. So he's really just the most adorable thing. Speaking of adorable, my next project is going to be Una Owl, which I am doing with Elizabeth of Savory Sewing to celebrate her recent birthday. I guess it was last month now, but that's okay. Now, she is a busy stitcher, and she happens to like Halloween, so this is spooky spring for Elizabeth. But we are doing Una Owl. Now, Una is, I'm finding all of the ones that I forgot to put the little piece of paper on to remind me who it is. The Artsy Housewife. She's got more than one Una available at this point. This, I am doing the first one. I am doing this with Roxy Flossco floss conversion, and I am doing this on Picture This Plus, Fiber on a Whim Mint. And here is my Una. My goal this week was to actually be able to show you that she was a bit of an owl, and indeed, this little eye, it's almost like she's got these eyelashes. Like, I fully feel that Una is a little girl owl. I think she's adorable. Now, this is 20 count, so I'm only using one strand of floss, but it's got good coverage. I think this is going very well. There's very light mottling in that particular, this is called Grassy, I believe. No, Grassy is what I'm using in a different one. I will actually have you consult with Evertote with regards to how they set up their conversion. I think it's delightful. I'm wondering if I'm going to actually stitch this more than once. I'm curious as to what she would be like if I did her one over one on 25. Wouldn't she be adorable? So she is a lovely stitch and just so much fun. My next thing is my mystery stitch announcement that I am using Ink Circle's Garden of Zig. Now, this is something that I'm doing that has no details allowed. And the Hathaway stitchers. I am finding that, so I'm trying to figure out my way to doing this without just reading a script, so it's a little bit more natural. And I thought, oh, I've got it. I'm going to put all the information on the little chit at the bottom of my stitch. But I'm forgetting to put things on this. So I will get better, I promise. And I apologize for some of this. But the Hathaway stitchers are sisters. Ooh, say that fast 5 times. And what they do is they host a mystery where they tell you what the pattern is. And all of us have a specific period of time to stitch this. Laura at Stitching by the Shore is doing this also. You're not supposed to show anybody what the fabric is that you're using or what the colors are. There's going to be a reveal at the end. Now, I have contacted them and said, so how's the reveal going to go? Is it going to be a Zoom? Like, it would be so much fun to do a Zoom where we all came on and then we revealed and it was video recorded as one of their floss tubes. Just a thought. So Aaron and, I was going to say Cassidy, that's not right. I apologize, I've forgotten your name. They are fabulous to watch. Right now, my mystery stitch is on a mystery linen or even weave or Aida with a mystery set of floss. I am at the present time 12%. And for those of you who know, we're supposed to be done by the last day of is it May or is it April? Wow, if it's April, I need to get busy, huh? I really want to try and get this done. So I think I'm going to actually put it in with the owl into a daily circulation so that I get it done. So Hathaway Stitchers, in case you aren't watching, please do. Okay, my next one is Dragon Keeping Time, which is a Maria Brovko of Cute Patterns by Maria Pattern. And I am doing this on 32 count Pell Stitches Even Weave. It is a Lagana. And it is called Rumbling Thunder. Oh, at least I wrote that one down. And I just thought that was the perfect name and the perfect look for a dragon. My husband loves dragons. And yes, indeed, he likes purple. So what better than a purple dragon? Now, at this point, my goal this week was to make sure that this no longer looked like a champagne glass, but that it looked like an actual hourglass. Now, when we look at this, I've got to say that it sparkles very nicely for having no crinuck, nothing glittery in there, no light effects, nothing. That is just how Maria did her shading of those yellows. Is that not genius? And then you can see that I've got part of the wing going upward here. And then this is a tail that's coming down and will swoop around. So I am delighted with this. Now, let's see, I've got my statistics here. I am at 8,999 stitches. No, for some reason I did not make that extra one stitch. And that means that I'm past 50%. I'm at 61.9%. So that is exciting. And I am doing this with regards to the Year of the Dragon 2024 Sal that is being run by the Samantha, the Huga Stitcher, and Erica of Fibers and Floss Canada. They are two absolutely wonderful, well, they are best friends, but they run separate floss tubes. They occasionally meet up and have one together. And Erica in particular is quite definitely a multi-crafter. And Samantha is somebody who's actually had to work on increasing her whips, because she came into this with very few. And I understood, because that's the way I was as well. So that was Dragon Keeping Time. Now my next one is actually one that I'm terribly excited about, because I have started a new sal, sew along, stitch along. It is a start along for me. Now, as soon as the releases became public, I fell in love with In Praise of Pollinators by the Blue Flower. Is that not gorgeous? So, I have started a sal, and I thought I had a piece of paper here with the name Praising Janine's Pollinators. Janine is the first name of the designer, and I would really love to acknowledge her every time I put a posting into Instagram by including her in the title. Now, this has been interesting. Now, first of all, this very, very clear pattern. Very clear. It is easy to follow. I am used to Pattern Keeper, and it's not affecting me going to this one. I will say that there are some printed patterns that I have a hard time changing to. Not this one. So, this has been a journey already. It's the first time I'm showing it to you, and it's a journey. So, here's the thing. I went to Stitch It Central, and I purchased some 36 count linen in shale color that was so gorgeous. And I started it, and I went, oh, I'm not liking the 1/1 coverage here. So I unstarted it. And I started again. Now these were center starts. I started it again with 2 threads. And I got 16 stitches in, and I went, right, this is the reason that you rarely see the owl stitching on 36. Because one strand seems too thin and two strands seem too thick. And I, at this point, have not collected enough of the range of colors available in my 12-weight sulky to be able to do a conversion myself. I will probably take individual elements out of this and make like an ornament out of a few of these different things and use sulky for that. And then I can use my 36. But, so that's been unpicked again. And so understanding that a fair amount of time went into what am I going to do next, I did get started and I decided to go to a 20 count fibers on a whim. And this is called parchment. So first of all, if I just show you the piece of fabric, isn't that pretty? I happen to have ordered it in the last time I did an order with 123 stitch. I actually don't order often because I've got two really good suppliers of stuff here. I like the feel of fiber on a whim cotton. It has a way of having substance, so it's not thin, but that it's soft in the hand while you're stitching, so that if you are a hoop stitcher, hi, that's me, you can put a hoop on it. I use a hoop that's oval, that's about this big, and I just simply move my hoop around and I take it off every time I leave stitching for 10 minutes or more. Sometimes I even do it just to go to the washroom. So I do find this is lovely, and I know that Cheryl at the Two Bay Stitchers was wondering, and this is where I actually messaged immediately. I was even only partway through watching the video when I put it down because I didn't want to forget that I would recommend this. I'm sorry that I can't get it in Ontario and send it to her. This is my start. So, yes, Carlene and Marlene, I didn't end up starting in the middle as I promised you. But this is also why I made my start along that loose. Now, here's the thing. If you would like to do this to be focused on a finish, I totally get it. I want it on my wall too. I just don't know how this is all going to play out with everything I do. Laura of Lala D Stitches, she does stitching and quilting. She is running a hashtag pollinators, Sal, and she has divided up this pattern so that you would finish it. Was it 12 or 8 sections? I'm going to invite you to watch her videos. Now, her particular Sal is not starting till later on in April. So if you're looking at this going, oh my goodness, but I didn't order it, do not fear. I got mine from Lindy Stitches and they had it to me quickly. So give them a contact in case your LNS doesn't have it, and kit it up, because she's not starting until later. And honestly, feel free to start anytime. If you're not watching this video until February of 2025, I would still love to have you start this project because it's gorgeous. And I would love to have you use my hashtag, but just in case Instagram does what Instagram is doing now, which is very inconsistent, if you could please hashtag tag me, the Stitching Owl, in, I would really appreciate that. And I always like to tag in the blue flower as well, so she can appreciate how many of us are enjoying her work. So if I do this, I am on the bat. Now, the thing that I have discovered in the little bit that I have stitched is that this could be a color completion piece, where you can do an outline and then fill in. Now, I often don't do that because I don't like to have a ridge going around the outside if everything's the same color. So, first of all, I've learned just do half of the X as you make your landmarking lines and then finish that X as you're filling it in, and then it goes smoothly. But also on this one, the color here, like if I show you, she's already outlined it for me with a different color. So if it turns out that this stands out a bit on the edge, That's all lovely, because that gives dimension to the pattern. So I might be able to use this at stitch north. Yes, you heard me right. I did not think I was going to stitch north in April. And if you're thinking, April's right now, yep, you're right. April's right now. Caroline announced there was a couple of spots available. And I got thinking, I wonder. It was, the spots were available for week number one. I know that you can go completely on your own and be happy. I did that the last time, and I wasn't alone for long. But I did decide to reach out to Lisa, the Forest City Stitcher, and ask whether she was doing week one. Well, all of the stars aligned, and she said, why, yes. And I have rented a room and don't have anybody to share the room with, even though there's two king-size beds. Would you like to come along with me, and I'll be doing the driving? And I was like, I can't be handed this anymore. Like, this is the perfect situation. And then when I asked my husband about that weekend, he went, oh, I have to work all that weekend, just go. Delightfully, he didn't even ask how much it's going to cost. So I am going to Stitch North week one, and I was searching for something that could have finishing elements in it. So I think I'm going to be taking my pollinators to my retreat. So I'm very, very excited. Yes, very excited. Okay, so that was my next one. And now going on, I have Garden Gnome, which is a Nenni design on Etsy. This is on 20 count cornflower Ada. And I would say, fiber on a whim. Yes, it's the same feeling as fiber on a whim. Okay, so this is going to be fiber on a whim. Now, this is the bottom part of a gnome. So you can see his garden basket full of flowers. This is the edge of his beard. I got his nose in just for you. So I need to do more beard, and then I've got this hat to go up here. So this is a 20 count cornflower Ada. And so I'm only using one strand. Now, I would say maybe two of the colors match exactly, and the other colorings are simply inspired by the original. Now, in here, I have 2,615 stitches. That means I am over 50% on this. So that's the second thing that's over 50%. So I'm at 53.9%. And this particular one can be used for Laura Stitching on the Shore, I Spy. Something that makes you laugh. The garden gnomes just make me laugh. And honestly, I love just putting gnome cross stitch into Etsy and seeing how many different ways different people have enjoyed making gnome cross stitches. So I've chosen one that's going to be, so it's going to top off at about that big. But you can get them much bigger if you'd like more of a true to life gnome. So I am very happy with that. Now my next one is actually a modern folk embroidery. And this is the Peacock Tree, which I am doing as part of Carmen of Cardamom Pins on Flosstube, Jacob Sleeper Sal. She invited us to go on his website, and instead of doing the latest greatest, well, no, you could stop and do that too. She wants you to do that too. But she also wanted you to look at some of his earlier works and say, yeah, they're a gem too. So My peacock tree, it is charted in one color, but Jacob is fine with us modifying that. And so I'm using three colors. They are Roxy Floss. So I'm using teal, my heart, teal for the peacock, graphite, which is a gray, and grassy, which is a green. Those are all Roxy Flosses. And this is on 32 count sage linen, which continues to be absolutely awesome. It is also a Roxy. So this is where I am. I got all of this peacock in. This border is minus the grassy on the outside, but you can see that this part is almost 50% done. If I just stopped there, I would have been at like 48% or something. But I love how the teal comes out on this. I am using two strands on this one. And I'm debating whether I add some beads to the peacock or not. In some ways, it almost seems not appropriate to bead something by... Well, I was going to say by Jacob, but I've already done it. I've taken some of his Quakers and beaded them and sent them off. Never mind. I'll have to think that out. So, where am I with the peacock tree? Well, I am at 2,496 stitches. And yes, you guessed it. This is 55%. So this is my third thing past 50%. Now, if I talk about being past 50%, that means that I reached that point in the last 2 weeks. And that was something that I was striving for. And another one of my whips. This is a Cottage Garden Samplings, and this is called Have Faith. It's part of the, Cottage Garden Sampling. I already said it. Okay, so I am doing this with one strand on 20 count Ada Cloud Break. So this is the one that I started on 32 count and was not happy. So I skipped past the 36 and went right to the 20. Now, if some of you are saying, did you ever think of just doing 40 count linen? Yes, I have. At the present time, I actually find the 40 count linen a little tricky when you... I have migraines a lot, and I use my stitching to stay sane. When I want it to be small, I'm going to use 20 count Ada because I can still stitch even if I'm in the middle of a headache. Occasionally, I have to turn all the lights out and just... but for the most part I use my stitching to help me. So this particular bird is on 20 count. It is a Roxy Floss cloud break, and I don't have numbers specifically, but I know I got past halfway on this because I'm not going to do the entire picture. So if I show you, this is the entire picture. I've taken out the bottom. I've taken out the house. And I don't know what of this I'm going to leave in. So at the present time, I've reached my goal here of having a bird. So you'll notice that I only have two bluebells here instead of the three that the other pattern does. So I have the option of coming up here and doing another swoop I'm trying to decide, do I add a swoop down here for balance to balance that out? I think maybe that'll be what I'll do, that I'll add a leaf down here rather than more blue up here. I think maybe that's enough blue. So I'm wondering, is it Kim the contented needleworker, is this what you do? Do you plan to the nth degree ahead of time exactly what the pattern's going to be when you're doing a little bit of editing? Or do you get some things done and then go, oh, I'm going to add this, I'm not going to do this that I thought I might have? What is your process? Maybe you could mention a little bit about that, just that your process in your next video. She's got a delightful video series. And when she is with her friends after a retreat, oh my word, the laughter is contagious. I am not done my whips yet. And yes, I'm only showing whips that I actually touched. Now, I will admit that I touch almost all of my whips in the 2-week period. So this week, I was trying to do, yes, you guessed it, the Jardin Privé birdhouse salle that is being co-hosted by Colette, the Highway Stitcher, as well as Brenda, the Handwork Maniac. This is March. This is actually that single pattern that I showed you earlier. So this is a work in progress, even though I was fully finishing some of the other months. Now, here's the thing. If you're wondering why the Stitching Owl has a purple four-leaf clover, I really can't answer that question well, other than when I looked at the pattern, it didn't register that it was a four-leaf clover, and I wanted to get some color. Because I've got to be honest, even Colette is getting tired of stitching these white posts. There won't be picket fences in her next one. But So I made that purple, and it wasn't until I was like up here that I went, hang on, that was supposed to be a four-leaf clover. But this is 28 count Panettone 1/1. Do you know how hard it is to take out 28 count 1/1? We're just going to say we have a purple four-leaf clover on this one and call it a day. Now that I can, might do, there could be a bird flying over top of here, or I might do this. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to compare that and say, okay, size-wise, this went up a little bit higher. So I could actually add the bird up here. And yeah, probably that's what I'll, and as such, this is a whip, not a finish. Okay, let's count off though. October, November, December, January, February, March. And I've got part of September done. I got to the 6-month level. So I'm 50% done the sal, and I haven't fallen behind. Yay! So this is cool. Okay. Is she finished with her whips? No, she's not. I don't have all the proper information here. So I purchased this pattern by Tiny Modernist Day Signs, and there is a sal that is being sponsored by, and this is off the top of my head, Julie in Stitches and the Peacock Stitcher. So it's 4 smalls and they're quite adorable. I'm doing this one because Laura's iSpy channel asks for something with clouds. Aha, clouds. And one of her other prompts is to iSpy something that's a puddle. And I'm gonna go, well, I'm sure we can't see it, but there will be a puddle under the cloud, because otherwise we wouldn't have the rainbow, right? We'll see whether she goes for that logic. I might have to be a little bit more into getting something with water. Anyway, these are lovely patterns. The inside pattern, like this is firm cardstock. You're not going to destroy it. And I'm just going to show you like that. We've got a lovely colored pattern. Now, this is another one that I started Thursday, and I started on 32 count. Oh, I think it was the other corner of the Aqua Splash. And so I stitched around and stitched around, and I had checked the size of this small before I started to stitch. And I went, oh, 5.5 by 5.5, okay. But as I stitched, it just didn't feel right. For the size of small that I do to make into an ornament, it was feeling too big. And then I started going, you know, I want some purples in there. I'm feeling purples and pinks. So what I did was I stopped, and then this morning I restarted this. I wanted to be able to say I started, because the sow started on April 1st, and I did start it that day, but I just haven't kept that. So what I have here is a 20 count Lugana in the color Mushroom. And I know most of the time with our Luganas, we want a higher number than that, but I'm doing it over one because I wanted to see, well, no, I didn't want to see. I'm going to go back a bit. When I went to Stitch It Central, one of their workers, lovely young lady by the name of Kat, who chats with me on a regular basis when I go in, I was bemoaning the fact that there wasn't a 40 count even weave because my eyes deal better with even weave than with the linen, because sometimes the inconsistencies in linen are just such that it's very easy to make mistakes. Now, I bet many of you are going to go, it's not your eyes, Karen, it's just the way it is. Be that as it may, I don't like my meditative stitching to be frustrating. And so she said, well, if you wanted 40 count over two, why not 20 count over one? And just use something like 12 weight. Kat, you're awesome. Thank you so much. I am trying to convince her to do a floss tube as well. I will announce her, I promise, if she does it. So what you're going to find is that I used my Sulky 12 weight and the colors aren't even close. No, no. So I'm trying to make this edge here look like it's old lace by using a Sulky variegated that's ice blue. So it doesn't, like, the darkest little spot briefly is right there. It's really an ice color. And then by edging it with a mauve, if we get it closer, you can see that that is actually a very light purple. I was able to do that in 45 minutes. This 1/1 is a fast 1/1, and my stitches were not sliding around as I expected. Sometimes on Lugana, you think, well, it's gonna try and hide that understitch. I haven't had that problem. So I'm excited about this now. I know that mine are going to look 100% different. But this ice blue is what color I'm going to use for my clouds, because I feel that's there, and I'm going to use pink and purple in the corner flowers. And I'm not sure how I'm going to do the rainbow, whether I'm going to do a Roy G. Biv or be creative. Anyway, I'm having fun and I'm glad that I got that restarted. And again, that particular pattern, if you're used to Pattern Keeper, it's not a problem to use. We all know it and love it. And look, this is a Jacob pattern from Modern Folk Embroidery. And right here, I am again using variegated, very light yellow silky thread on 32 count blue moon. My goal was to get this center star done. And while I don't have all the feathered parts of the star done, I do have the star itself. Now with this one, I am at 14,733 stitches. I'm going to lean back. It is saying that's 27%. But once I get this part over here, I'm going to mirror this here and be done. I don't have enough material to do all of the pattern. Do I have it here? I do. So if I show you the pattern, I've been doing this. There's this beautiful motif here. I would get to about here and run out of space. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do this as a whole separate project. So I'm going to get to this bottom part here and then put that part here facing upwards, and it will fit on this piece of gorgeous Pell Stitches fabric. I'm so proud of this. So I started this for the Jacob Palooza that was in October of 2023, put on by Evertote. And it is my hope to have this finished by the time Stitch North is on in October 2024. Okay. So do I know that that is over 50% done? Not for sure, but I suspect so. And the one everybody waits for a while I thought you guys were getting bored of seeing my Stained Glass Owl by Shirova Creations. But so many of you have commented that it's so lovely to see it progress that I'm not going to skip using it each time. And I definitely won't skip it today, because today, let me see, where's my piece of paper? I had this. Ah, found it. Okay, so I am stitching with all called for colors, and I'm doing one strand of DMC on 20 count charcoal Aida that is just off of a bolt and quite crispy, but it's not crispy anymore, I promise you. Now, today I am reporting that what you are going to be seeing is 81,544 stitches, which means that yes, I got to 50%. This is 50.96%. And I am thrilled. It is more tummy feathers. There we go. So with this red swoop, this in here looks like one big blob of black, but I promise you that it's a variety of blues in there. They're just the deep blues. So I want to come down here. He's got talons that are to come up very soon here. And so as such, I want to get this done before I go over here. I might have to start gridding again soon. But that is over 50% done. I am so pleased. And thank you for all the wonderful support on Instagram that you're giving me. It is absolutely awesome. Now, speaking of owls for a moment, I'm going to say that I was not successful at my magazine monthly challenge last month. You could do just the word balloon or hot air balloon. I did not get the second L of balloon done. I got one little of waxing moon done, but I didn't even get started on the other one. And I just decided I had to let it go. And I hadn't taken the pictures, so even when it came to Laura's iSpy challenge, she did not get the support I should have given her. So I'm going to do it differently this month. And I'm going to go back to how I did it originally, where I just post as I go. Now, what I did in January, no, February. What I did in February to make the Magazine Monthly Challenge work is that I took their acrostic word and said, how many of these letters can I make work around an owl? And so that time it happened, I could get the whole thing so that it was about an owl. And as such, it was absolutely awesome. Now, a couple of my lovely subscribers have been really, really good about going, you know, if an R comes up, it's a raptor. You know, if T comes up, he's got talons. That is absolutely fabulous, and thank you. This month, I actually tried to come up with an owl alphabet. If anybody can come up with a J, K, X, Y, Z for an owl alphabet, I would really love to have some more words. And I'm wondering, can you show her? My puppy has gone for her haircut and she is going to have a little show. Thank you, hubby. So this, and she doesn't like staying on command. So this is Lola. And Lola's waiting for Jeff to give her a treat, and she knows the treats come from the next room. That's as long as my visit's going to be. She does have Jeff wrapped around her little paw. She's continually getting treats. It's very true. So I'm just going to exit for a moment. So my invitation was, if you had any more words.
What about you? You want a little treat too? Something from the other room?
Oh my goodness. So, this month.
You're blushing.
Maybe. So this month, the acrostic word is... seriously. Rowboat. And the theme is down the river. So here we go. I'm going to put on my glasses. I said that I could use my owl for down the river because they live in trees by rivers frequently. Rowboat. R, raptor. Thank you very much. O, owl. W, wings. B, beak. O, owl. A, airborne. And T, talons. Thank you very much. So what I have said is that for the main theme, I'm going to stitch 500 stitches, and that for each of the letters, I'm going to stitch 350 for a total of 2,950 stitches this month. So I will post today a picture on Facebook of where I am and what the stitch count is, and we will see where this goes. Now, I am going to say to you that I joined in a challenge by Jen the Caffeinated Stitcher and Alara, who are both wonderful floss tubers, on YouTube, and they both have a nice long YouTubes if you want to do what I do and force yourself to walk for an hour and 10 minutes. It's great to have company while you're doing it. Also, if you have to do backstitching and things like that, it's wonderful. What their challenge is 25,000 stitches on the same project in 25 weeks. So my goal, based on where, so I started February 1st at 56,904, which means that my goal for 25,000 stitches is 81,904. Today, I'm at 81,544. I will bet that I have my 25,000 stitches done by the end of this week. It's really exciting, but it's also why that bird is coming together so quickly. And I know I have had a few people say, are you not getting tired of it? And the answer is no. I am so excited by what I'm seeing and inspired by the color combination that no, I am not. I'm going to say that with a caveat. I do have a little bit of OCD in me. It is what made me a wonderful musician, is that I would sit and keep practicing until it was right. And why I can compose and teach theory. It's just part of who I am. And as such, when I get excited about a stitch, I want to stitch on it every single day. So, yes. So no, I am in no way bored whatsoever. So I do have April Magazine Monthly done. Laura's prompts, you heard me talking along the way about clouds, something that makes me laugh. She has something blue, well, there's blue feathers. A circle, well, I'll have to make an ornament of something. Related to the earth, the owl is part of flora and fauna, which is of the earth. I'm getting it in everywhere, people. Something expensive, the owl, because it's the one that has had the most amount of DMCs to purchase. And I wanted to purchase everything new, so I knew how much DMC I was going through. I did purchase a cone of black. I did. Starts with A, well, airborne owl. Butterfly. We just might see a butterfly start. Rain and puddles, you heard me talking about rain and puddles earlier. And a way to travel. Well, flying is a way to travel. And owls certainly have that hands down under control. And there you have it. There is mostly my whips for this week and what I've been doing. So in here, as I just give you a few quick moments for floss tubers, I know I've mentioned some of my favorites along the way. I think I may have forgotten to say Amy as being the instigator to the Do You Want to Stitch a Songbird Sal? So she's renewing stitches on Floss Tube. So one just wonderful shout out from me is to Leanne and Jeannie of Loose Thread Stitchers. They are fabulous. Now, they've been on for a while. They are not new. They stitch so much. And between them, they balance each other well in what their interests are, their chatter. They are always informing each other. I would just love to go shopping with them. They do go shopping together and enjoy that outing. They quilt together as well. They both quilt. I don't know whether they quilt together. One of the things we discover is that there is a big tank at the background and that it is not your typical fish tank. It is full of turtles. And not turtles, turtles. Well, it turns out that you will have the opportunity to learn turtle tidbits on a regular basis and see albino turtles. And I just find it fascinating. Now, they give you the heads up in case you aren't interested, that you can turn it off, that's what's going to happen. But I don't think you're going to want to turn it off. It is absolutely marvelous. There is a hashtag to come called the Herschel and Lucy Sal. So that is something that I am joining with Carolyn Zook of See Zook Stitches in stitching one of the Herschel patterns that has been created by the Stitching Mommy. So we're starting mid-month. There's still time for you to download and gather your resources should you want to join us. It's going to be fun. And the Herschel pictures are not massive nor full coverage. So I think that we're going to be able to do them and see a finish. Now, for other stitchers, Wicked Cat Stitch, it is putting out fun videos with clear speaking. Logical goals are set, but I love that she isn't so married to them that she can nudge them aside. So that is lovely. Cross Stitch Sarah with some underscores is a lovely British floss tuber who really likes, here we go, Kim, she loves to stitch birds. Now, she's a solid presenter, even though she's only got two out. She's brand new. Give her a little bit of time. Sharon's Crafty Creations. Sharon has crafted for over and stitched for over 35 years. She is ready to do a good floss tube. She is early as well in how many she's got going. The Vino Stitchers are a mother-daughter pair who are, I think they've got two, maybe three uploads in the last month. They share a little clink of the wine glass in name of a new wine of the night, and then are showing their stitching that has wide variety, and they just have fun together. It's a nice rapport between mother and daughter. I do enjoy when people are like that. And then last but not least, I would like to say, if you don't have time for anything but you really need a laugh because it's been a tough day, while you cook the supper or fold the laundry, put on the Thread Gremlins. These are two friends that get together and they laugh. They talk about stitching as they laugh. Yes, they absolutely do. They are worth watching. They are just uplifting. It is fun. It makes us smile, even if we are having to frog at that moment. So I invite you to try out some of those new floss tubers. As always, the projects and the floss tubers that I mention will be listed below. Floss tubers will have links, and there will also be something that identifies my next area called Moment for Music. I had to think about it for a moment because I actually recorded this earlier in the week and was like, what did I record? So today I am taking you back in time. And I do know that there are many people who will go, uh-oh, I don't really do the Baroque and classical thing. And I get that. We have to remember that during anybody's lifetime, they were the popular music of the day. So in Bach's time, which was also the time of Handel and Scarlatti, they were the pop music. Why were the repeat signs all over? Because there was nothing to record. If they did not say themes over and over and have repeat signs, the chances of somebody remembering the melody were few. They needed repeat signs in order to be memorable. So a lot of this early music has a lot of repeat signs that, for the most part, in today's society, we ignore. So if we think back to the fact that at some point, every piece of music was new and was the pop music of the day, it gives us a new perspective. It makes us wonder what the rest of their day was like. And this is something that I encourage my students to think about as they look at learning the foundations that lead to the music of today. My goal, my students personally, is to make sure that whatever kind of music they love, they can make it for the rest of their life. That is my one goal for every child who comes to see me. And every adult. I teach a lot of adults. So today, it's not J.S. Bach that you're going to be hearing. It is C.P.E. Bach. And a piece called Solfeggietto. A solfeggio is actually a piece that is normally sung, and it doesn't have words. It is an actual study that is meant to be done to just pure vowels like A, E, A, O, U, and is about the purity of tone. So when we have Solfeggietto put onto the piano, we have a situation where the right hand and left hand work together most of the time to create a single melodic line. And it's supposed to be that if you close your eyes, that you would not be able to tell when I changed from my right hand to my left hand, that I have control of the technique, which is what a solfeggio is about, the purity of the technique. That's what this purity is. So now this is a brief, quick piece that would have originally been played on harpsichord. So dynamics are often sudden rather than with monstrous crescendos and decrescendos. And the touch is incredibly clear. It is a piece that is what we call the grade 8 level here in Canada, and that students love to play. My fondest memory for this piece is taking it out of context. I was playing at a church, filling in during a period of time where they couldn't find somebody to play permanently. And they had an organ that was a computer where they could buy the organ sounds of the different churches in England. So you could buy Westminster Abbey. I can't remember what the abbey was. This was a major abbey in Britain. And so I literally pulled all the stops. Well, they were buttons because this was a computer. And I played solfeggio at full tilt with four different manuals available to me. And no, it was never meant to be played that loud. I had the stained glass windows rattling, and it was a glorious moment. So, this is not on organ, this is on piano. Solfeggietta by C.P.E. Bach. So much that you would give part of your time to me, and that so many of you will leave such positive comments below so that I continue to smile. It is as if you are sending me a smile with each one of those comments that you leave. I pray that each of you is healthy and that all of the people in your family are healthy, and that you are looking forward to the next weeks with spring arising out of nothing in the earth. I'm sure it's further than it is here in Canada. I hope that this is a sign of new life and that it renews your interest in making things beautiful. I hope that you had your needle, thread, and fabric in hand as you watch today, and that you made yourself happy as you made something beautiful. Until next time, bye-bye for now.